This is an X10 appliance module that I used for turning my dust collector on and off here in the shop. It became unreliable. You never knew when it was going to turn on or off or if it would, so I replaced it. Thought it'd be interesting to take this apart and see how it was made. I removed these four screws and take this cover off. And this is hardwired to these three pins. And these bayonet plugs have been pressed on there and then soldered. And the black wire is getting pinched between this piece of plastic and the back of this unit. This wire should have been routed over here, like so. That's not an issue with this, but just a little bit of sloppy assembly. This is not really, that might have been the problem right there. How about that? Okay, so let's see if and that one just came out. Let's see if this one comes out. So, a very poor job of connecting these plugs to the end of the wires. They all but fell out of there on their own. Anyway, these are not really intended to come apart. We'll take it apart anyway. I want to see what's inside here. The inside of that looks like. And you've got these dials here that sets the code for when this will go on and off in response to a code that's set on the remote. Take out a few more screws. This is more in line with what I was expecting to find and the way it was acting. This thing has turned on and off so many times it's flashed these contacts. They are carboned up or pitted, and that's why it would sometimes work and sometimes wouldn't. I pulled the contact arms out, and you can see these are very burnt and deeply pitted. So that's the main reason for the failure. The fact that the wires were about to fall off was a secondary issue. Pull out the other side of the contacts. They're burnt as well. Interesting the way this would work, this cam lobe would operate on this pin on both sides. The solenoid would trigger one way. It would allow the contacts to close. Your remote has two buttons, on and off. When you hit on, the cams would come down and allow those contacts to close. And when you hit off, it would actuate the solenoid again. It would spread the contacts. Solenoid coil, when it's energized, this plunger goes in this direction. The spring returns it. This fits in here. Every time this moves, the end of this plunger hits the lobes of this cam. And this flips back and forth like one of our flip-flop mechanisms in the marble machines. The wipers on the back of these setting discs and where they make contact on the back side of the circuit board. This module gets used quite a bit. Some days I might turn the dust collector on and off 30-40 times, maybe more. They do wear out.